Myself Seth Singh, I'm head of the school in Navyogi School Lodhi Road, and today the topic of discussion is physical world. When we talk about physical world, our meaning is the physics related to the nature and to understand the phenomena of physics in nature. So there are three basic questions based on curiosity which opens as what, why and how. What means what is physics? And why means why I have to study the physics, and the last one is how should I study the physics. So when we talk about the physics, we must know that physics means nature. Thus, it is a natural science that involves the study of matter and its motion through space, time, along with the related concepts such as energy and force. More broadly, it is the general analysis of nature conducted in order to understand how the universe behaves. So, in the physical world, we involve largely the whole universe and the activity and events going on in the universe. Physics covers a wide range of phenomena from elementary particle to the largest particle. And when we say the elementary particle, we talk about the atoms and the particles smaller than atoms, and when we talk about the larger particles or larger bodies, we means the planets, the stars and other things. So, we are interested to know what is happening in our surroundings through the bodies which are very much physical, which can be measured, which can be seen, which can be observed. Now, let us have a look about the bodies which are in our surrounding and directly affecting us. These bodies may be the plants, may be the mountains, may be the rivers, and how the water is flowing through the rivers. So, all these small concerns we deal in the physics. So, sometimes physics is called the fundamental science or the fundamental physics. Physics is very interesting subject and it has a very large scope, and along with the scope, it also gave excitements. So, the science of physics, which is determined that matter is transformation of energy, and it limits and it delimits also. The energy is being converted from one form to another form. That is why it has a very important role to understand how this transformation of energy is taking place from one form to another form, and this leads us to observe many events which are going on in our surroundings. That is why we say that physics is the fundamental science and it is the science of sciences, and in this excitement is very important. What I am reading, what I am learning, what I am observing, what I am calculating, it gives me the excitement. When I saw a rainbow in the sky, why the colors rainbow are 7 in number and which one is at upper level and which one is lower level, it gives me the excitement. How this rain is taking place, it gives me the excitement, and I become interested to know the science of it, the physics of it. That is why physics gives very excitement, and this is a firm belief of the people that physics is meant for us, physics is invented by us, and physics is very useful to us according to its scope and its excitement. The first and foremost is the appearance of motion. The entire universe is constantly on the while, but the basic character of energy is inertia. It cannot be stir its own. So, if motion is must as it is, then how could energy take to motion? This is the interest, this is the scope of physics. Even if it be an accident, it must have the cause of it, and we are interesting to know the cause so that we can avoid the accident. So, the source of generated motion is the inertial energy must over the beyond energy, and it must be dynamic as well. As energy does not decay and does not subject it to any loss or gain, so we say that energy is conserved, which affected motion, and we must enjoy an independent existence of its own. And there are two types of domain which are the interest of physics, that is macroscopic and macroscopic. In macroscopic domain, we study the phenomena involving objects of finite size, or you can say that terrestrial size or the astronomical scales, and this model is known as the classical physics. In microscopic, we learn about some very, very small particles like elementary particles, theory of relativity, atoms, nuclei, and other particles. In classical physics, as we see that it is developed in the up to the year of 1900. It includes the study of mechanics, gravitation, heat, sound, light, electricity, magnetism. But when we talk about microscopic, we study the quantum physics, theory of relativity. And there is one important things that learning without thought is labor lost. This is the soul of the physics. If someone know the concept of physics but not able to apply its understanding to the phenomena which are taking place in our surrounding, then it is useless. So we have to study the physics, we have to understand the physics, and we have to apply the physics in our day-to-day life. Then only the physics will become very interesting, and we can understand its scope, and it will give the excitement, and it will be very, very useful in every walk of life. Physics is the most basic in all of the sciences, and it has played a vital role in the development of all other sciences. It involves the concept of, suppose we are going to have excitement and we are going to determine something on the basis of knowledge. If someone knows the concept of density and relative density, and using this concept determines purity of a substance like milk and gold, and obtains the result which is very close to the reality, and it is as similar result as Archimedes found the purity of gold of crown of the king, then physics becomes exciting and appreciable. If we know how a spring works, and we can use this spring as a shock absorber, as a equilibrium setup, then we say that we have studied the physics. And just memorizing the physics or just memorizing the science does not make our study useful. Physics has the sense of natural science. It is the study of nature, which is responsible for energy conservation and energy creation in the universe. So there is a conservation law of energy. And similarly, there are number of conservation laws like conservation law of momentum, conservation law of angular momentum, conservation law of symmetry, conservation law of parity. So these are the conservation law which are very much useful in the study of nature. The physics behaves, or the physics is the science for mankind, and it will continue to get closer to the ultimate truth of nature. A major preoccupation of physics is the study of elementary particles and their interaction. Physics answers the questions involving the behavior of non-living things in nature. So now you can understand the meaning of physical world and the phenomena taking place in our surrounding, which we have to study, and we have to study the laws which govern the nature and which are very much useful as an application. So when we talk about the application, we are talking about the society and technology. So we have created the society where technology is very much useful, and sometimes technology becomes the requirement, and sometimes study becomes the requirement to understand the technology. So when something is invented in the society, And that is the useful for the society. That's why physics has a great relation with the society and with the technology. Technology is meant for society and society is meant for technology. So, they are very close to each other. So, we must know that in the physical world, what is our role, what is physics and what is the science which we have to study and why I have to study, it is very important, and how we have to study is again an important task which physics makes very easier, very simple. Now, we can say that society is more science oriented and developed scientific attitude about most of the day to day activities. Now, we can understand our surroundings, we can use our surroundings and we can interact with the surroundings. So, this is the main theme of physical world. So, in physical world, we have learned about the surroundings, that is nature, and this nature is extended to the universe. Similarly, we have talked about some laws, which are the laws of conservation, and as you know that no change is possible without the cause, and this cause may be the force. So, in next part of the discussion, we will talk about the fundamental forces which exist in nature.